Lime. Brought to you by Helene Curtis, makers of Stop F deodorants, blowing cream, spray, and stick, suave hairdressing, and end and dandruff treatment shampoo. Now let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning What's My Line panel. First, the delightful star of stage and television, Miss Arlene Francis.
Thank you. I have introduced a great many people in the 8 years that I've been on What's My Line, but none with more pleasure than I introduced my husband, Martin Gable.
On my left, a girl who knows the difference between a flatted fifth and a diminished seventh, one of New York's leading jazz buffs, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Thank you, Martin. And on my left, our publisher panelist, who is rather proudly in the vanguard of the retrogressive jazz fans, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
I'd like to announce I'm strictly a Dick Rogers, Cole Porter, Jerry Kern man. Well, every television show but this one has a leading man. We have a misleading man. And here he is, John Charles Daly.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. Once again tonight, particularly after those comments by Mr. Bennett Cerf, it will be our mission to see what we can do to make life difficult for them for the better part of a half an hour. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the show, and we'll meet our first challenger in just 1 minute.
Stay tuned.
And now let's meet our first contestant. Will you come in and sign in, please?
Dale? Fogle, is that right? Mr. Fogle, where are you from?
New Kensington, Pennsylvania.
New Kensington, Pennsylvania.
That's right.
Where's that, dear?
It's about 18 miles from Pittsburgh.
Big family you have, too. How far from Pittsburgh?
About 18 miles from Pittsburgh.
18 miles from Pittsburgh. Mr. Fogle, the panel. Mr. Fogle. Now, will you come and join me over here? Do you know how we keep score, Mr. Fogle?
Yes, sir.
Fine. In that event, let's let this fine, enthusiastic audience in the theater and the people who are watching at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, Mr. Fogle is salaried, and let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Fogle, apart from being attractive, you look like a gentleman of some brawn. Is that useful to you in your work?
No, not necessarily.
Actually, it's a difficult question to give you guidance on. I would say I don't feel we can answer it no, because certainly an element of physical strength can be applied to so many occupations that I think Mr. Fogle might agree that this element certainly is usable and useful in this area. Would you say that?
Well, I want to thank you, John, because you're very generous tonight. Or are you giving me a no?
I'm just sick. With your permission, we'll give them a qualified no and leave it as a simplified yes. So you can
Mr.
Ahead.
Vogel, may I ask you this? Do people watch you do whatever it is you do?
Yes, they do.
Would you be considered in any way a performer?
No.
No. That's one down and nine to go. It is true that people do watch Mr. Vogel sometimes when he does what he does. Mr. Gable.
Is there a product, Mr. Fogle, involved in any way in what you do?
Well, phrased that way, I guess we'd have to say that, as is so often true, a product is involved. I would say the concentration here would be on service, but certainly there's a product involved here.
John, I'm very grateful for the peregrinations of your wide-ranging mind. Is it yes or no?
Yeah, there's a product involved.
Would I be able to make any use of your product, Mr. Fogle?
No.
No, I don't think so, Martin. That's too down a date to go, Miss Kilgallen.
All right, I'll bite. Would I?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Fogel, do you work for a non-profit making organization?
Yes, I do.
Non-profit?
That's right.
Gosh, I guessed that one right.
And you describe me as a misleading man, really, Bennett.
Would the non-profit making organization be, by some chance, some branch of the government?
No.
Well, now, some branch of the government, would you be?
I didn't mean only the federal government. Could be the state or city government.
Or a municipal government?
Is it a yes?
Or a county government, Bennett?
Yes. That's a no.
Or a hamlet government?
Is that all no?
No, it's a yes.
Oh, it's a yes. Well, is it correct that it's not the federal government?
That's right.
Is it a city or municipal government?
Yes.
Is it a government of a city in Pennsylvania?
Yes.
Is it Pittsburgh that you...
No.
That's four down and six to go, Miss Bennett.
Well, he's from near. Well, he said 18 miles from Pittsburgh.
Would I be correct in assuming you are not elected to whatever job this is?
That's right.
Is there anything distasteful about your work?
Not to Mr. Fogel, but there might be some who would consider that another pastime or occupation would be preferable.
Does it have anything to do with restraining people that might have behaved badly?
No.
That makes it five down and five to go, Mr. Gable.
Is it possible that your work principally does not have to do with people, Mr. Fogel?
Well, I would say principally it does not have to do with people.
Is your work done? Is your nonprofit job in the county within which New Kensington exists?
Yes.
Are there animals involved in what you do?
No.
Six
no,
people
four
to go. Miss Kilgallen.
No one on this panel, presumably, would have use for your services, and you do not deal principally with animals. Is that correct?
I don't believe the question has been asked as to whether anybody on the panel would have use for his services. In this specific case, if you mean specifically...
Well, Martin got a no on it, and
I
got a no...
On whether I could use his product.
His product.
Oh, ho, ho. Your product is not an animal?
No.
Yes.
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 Is your product something I could hold in my hand?
Yes.
Would I be unlikely to if I had the choice?
There are times when you would, by specific choice, hold it in your hand. So we'd have to give you a no on that. That makes it seven down and three to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Fogel, is the product that you sometimes use ever used by felons, crooks, robbers?
No.
I don't think so, Bennett. Eight down and two to go, Miss Francis.
Do you work out of doors?
Yes, I do.
Do you use your hands in this work?
Yes, I do.
Are the hands applied to something? This something that Dorothy says one can hold in one's hand, is that what you hold on to when you do this job?
Yes.
Does it in turn hold something?
No.
There's nothing in this product.
Well, yes, it does. It in turn holds something.
It in turn holds something. Is this something that it holds a liquid of any form?
Sometimes.
But Martin and I... Well, if you and Martin won't use it, it isn't the liquid I had in mind. And I don't know that it comes in powdered form yet either.
You may have 20 seconds for a conference.
Well, it might be a paint. Maybe does something. Maybe paint lines on.
Well,
the
I use paint.
Stuff.
No, I don't think it's something like that. It maybe does something in city maintenance of some kind.
Well, but what is this object you are narrowing it down to?
Well, maybe he kills off the mosquito plague or something.
All right, 20 seconds up. Miss Francis, please continue.
May I assume that you work in the maintenance department? of the city.
No.
I may not assume
that.
No, well, if I don't assume, I'd like to ask a few other things.
Well, that's good. $9.1 to go, Mr. Gable.
Have you anything to do with insects or...
No, they'd be animals.
Things of that... I beg your pardon.
But that's not his product.
The question I must assume to have been asked, so that'll be $10 and no more to go. Mr. Fogel is a garbage collector for New Kensington.
John, well, there may be no insects in your garden.
And what makes you think that the sweet, charming Miss Kilgallen holds garbage in her hands?
I have a picture in my mind's eye of Dorothy taking up the little waxed envelope of it and putting it in the container every day of her life. There we
Not
are.
Not Dorothy.
Let's see what we can do with the second
that,
challenge.
Believe anything.
Will you come in and sign in, please? Right there, please. N. N. Orloff. Right, sir? May we know what the N stands for?
Nicholas.
Nicholas Orloff. Where are you from, sir?
Long Island Oyster Bay, sir.
Long Island Oyster Bay.
Bay.
Mr. Orloff, the panel. Panel, Mr. Orloff. Will you join me over here now, please, sir? Do you know how we keep score?
Yes, I do, sir.
All right, then let's let the folks at home and everybody in the theater except my friends on the panel know what your line is. All right. Panel, Mr. Orloff is likewise salaried, and let's begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Mr. Orloff, do you work for a profit-making organization?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Cerf.
Mr. Orloff, do you work in or around Oyster Bay?
No, sir.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Do you work for some branch of the government?
No.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Gable.
Do you work for a charitable foundation of some kind?
No, sir.
Four down and six to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Is there any product involved in what you do?
No, ma'am.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Cerf.
Well, we're doing fine. Mr. Orloff, does the work that you do require some kind of special skill?
Yes, sir.
Well, would you call, might you come under the heading of an artist of some kind?
No.
No. Six down and four to go, Miss Francis.
Now, you say there is a product, correct?
No, the answer was there is no product.
Oh, I thought you said yes, that there was. I'm sorry. Must listen better. Mr. Orloff, would you wear the sort of thing that you now are wearing in your job?
Yes.
Do you work indoors?
Yes.
Do you work in an office?
No.
That makes it seven down and three to go, Mr. Gable.
Are you connected with any religious organization, Mr. Orloff?
No, sir.
Eight down and two to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Mr. Orloff, do you work?
Very hard, Mr. Orloff.
Oh, I suppose you do.
Do you use your voice in your work?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you ever talk on the telephone?
Not in the course of my work, no.
That is not, no.
Sure
this
may.
Is not necessary. That's nine down and one to go, Mr. Cerf.
We've eliminated pretty nearly everything. Have you got anything to do, Mr. Orloff, with education?
No, sir.
Ten down and no more to go. Mr. Orloff is a United Nations interpreter, as a matter of fact, chief interpreter for the United Nations for many years, and is specifically a Russian interpreter, and has been very busy these past few days at the United Nations Security Council and General Assembly.
Wonderful.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Wonderful to have you. Can you say goodbye to the panel?
Can I confess some special shame?
What?
I published a book by Mr. Orloff once.
Yes, Prince Orloff. Right. And now, we'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, here is a word from our alternate sponsor. Come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which my friends on the panel are blindfolded. Blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, we go to a different form of questioning. You will ask one question at a time in turn, proceeding clockwise, and let's begin it all with Bennett, sir.
Well, would it be more likely to see your name on page one of Variety than page one of the Wall Street Journal or the Congressional Record?
You never know.
I think yes would be a fair answer to that, Bennett. Miss Francis?
Are you in the field of entertainment?
Yes.
Are you now appearing in New York?
Yes.
Do you sing?
Yes.
Oh.
Are there two of you appearing as mystery guests tonight?
Yes.
We like to think of us as one.
Do you appear in television?
Occasionally.
Is your principal source of income the, at the present time, the legitimate stage?
Uh-uh.
1 down and 9 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Was that a no?
That was a no.
Did I get a yes to singing?
Yes.
Are you Edie Gourmet and Steve Lawrence?
Oh, no.
Who are, strangely, because so many strange things do happen in this business, the stars of the Edie Gourmet and Steve Lawrence show. Which is replacing for the
Steve
summer
Allen.
Our old buddy Steve Allen. Yes.
How could you possibly say occasionally when I said in television?
Well, it's only 8 weeks.
Well,
we only
have
two more to go. We thought occasionally.
Now, I must say that we had a small bit of control panic around here because Edie and Steve were way over in Brooklyn for their own show. And when we started on the air tonight, they weren't here, and we thought maybe they were caught in a traffic jam somewhere and might not make it. Yes, Dorothy?
I think that the only reason that we got it, and this has been, you know, the stupid panel of the year for the last few weeks, is because they have rapidly become the Lunt and Fontan of the record industry.
Oh.
And when you think of husbands and wives, you have to take it.
Now, I will add, if I may, one word, which I trust will not embarrass either of you, but because of the nature of television, its newness, we have had a chance to watch these two young people grow up and come to real fame and prominence, and I don't think two young people ever worked harder to get it or have carried it with so much grace. Our congratulations.
Thank
to
you,
both
Mr.
of you. Nice to have you here.
Thank you.
And just for the lady's sake, the dress that Miss Gourmet was wearing is what I would judge to be blush pink, because that's the way Bennett looks when he blushes. And there you are. And now we'll meet another contestant after this word from our sponsor. And now, panel, let's see what you can do with the final challenge. We'll get back here to the beginning, and would you sign in there, please?
That's some honest answers.
Did you hear what Mr. Surf said? Let's have some honest answers. Really? Carrie? Or Carrie Hooley, is that right? Now, is it Miss or Mrs. Hooley?
Miss.
Miss Hooley.
Yes.
And where are you from, Miss Hooley?
London, England.
London, England. How nice to have you here. Come
Thank
a long
you.
Way. You here for vacation?
Yes, for 5 weeks.
Ah, that's grand. I'm very glad you have a chance to come to New York, and particularly glad you could join us. Miss Hooley, the panel.
Thank you.
Four distinguished people.
Thank you.
But ruthless, cold, and cruel. Now, will you come over here and join me? I think perhaps you are not too familiar with our scorekeeping system if you've come all the way from London, although I do know that What's My Line is in London. But if you can give them properly a no to an answer to one of their questions, we flip a card, and when we flip 10 cards, you've won the game.
Yes.
It's as simple as that. And now, let's let the folks at home and our friends here in the theater know exactly what your line is. All right, panel. Miss Hooley is salaried. And let's begin the general questioning with Martin Gable.
Miss Hooley, do you do what you do in England?
Yes.
Rather than Wales or Scotland or the Isle of Man?
Yes.
Is what you do more likely to be done in the British Isles than in the United States, for example?
Yes.
Small problem here. Wait a minute. We'll have a conference if you don't mind.
No, John.
Mm-hmm. Right. I think, Martin, to be completely fair to you...
And I know you want to be.
I want to be. We'll give you a no. Actually, no, what Miss Hooley does is done equally in the United States. Miss Kilgallen.
John, just not by way of a question, but just by way of a clarification, would you say that it was done equally because of our greater population here, or is it done equally percentage-wise?
Well, now we'll adjourn this program for 3 days. We'll all come back. I can't be sure of the percentage. Let me say that in the normal social conditions which obtain in the two countries, you would find the incidence of this occupation as readily in the United States as you would in Great Britain. Oh,
that's what I wanted to know, John. Miss Hooley...
We've come to understand what you mean when you say that, John.
That's remarkable because I don't understand it myself yet.
Miss Hooley, do people come to you for your services?
Yes.
Is there a product involved in what you do?
No.
All right.
Two down a date to go, Mr. Sue.
To clear up something before we go on, Miss Hooley, the reason I questioned you before, John, was I thought anybody who worked for the U.N. was doing some kind of government work.
The question was, do you work for the government, as it was posed?
Was it?
Sorry, old boy. Stiff up a lip, though. And now we have blush pink
Not at all. I'm not sure you're right. We're going back to Miss Hooley. Miss Hooley, does the work that you do in any way connected with public service?
Yes.
Do you then work rather for the City of London, a public service, than for a private employer?
Yes.
Would you have anything to do with either...
Wait a minute. Sorry, I've got to have a conference. Bennett, your question was, do you work for the City of London rather than a private employer? We want to be sure.
For some governmental agency.
I see. Fine. That's a no that you get to that. That's 3 down and 7 to go, Miss Francis.
Do you get around in your job, Miss Hooley?
Yes.
Do you get around in a vehicle of some kind?
Yes. Yes.
Do other people get around in this vehicle with you?
Yes.
Would you say that you are in the transportation business in some form?
Yes.
Is it possible that you might drive a bus?
Drive a bus?
No.
What are you all applauding
for? But I want
to
thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for that round of applause.
Yeah, you get a no answer to that, too.
I don't care. Bear with me.
6 down and 4 to go. No, 4 down and 6 to go.
Do you drive a public vehicle of some kind?
No.
That's 5 down and 5 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Well, do you have anything to do with a public vehicle of any kind that I could ride in?
Yes.
Well, is it on something other than land?
No.
No.
That
no.
makes
She's
it...
She's a conductor.
Are you
She's
the conductor?
Conductor
of a
yes, Bennett. Yes. You got it. There we go. And Miss Hooley, you have come too far, so we'll flip the rest of them anyway, and thank you very much for being our guest. It was very nice to have you with us on What's the Line. Can you say good night to the family? And panel, thank you for a good, fun show. And on that happy note, this is John Daly saying good night, Miss Eileen Francis.
Good night, Mr. John. And I want to say hello to the task force that has arrived on our shores. Welcome to fleets and all that. Oh, and this is my husband. Good night, dear.
Good night.
Night, good night, Martin. Dorothy. See you later.
Yes.
Good night, Bennett.
And I on behalf of several other publishers in New York, would that pajama girl that was on last Sunday please send in her telephone number? Good night, John.
Good night, Bennett. And thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for being with us on What's My Line.
If you'd like to attend our broadcast and see the panel and our guests in person, write for tickets to What's My Line, CBS Television, 485 Madison Avenue, New York, 22, New York. Transportation for contestants on What's My Line is arranged by United Airlines. This has been a CBS Television Network production, in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Todman. Hal Sims speaking.